A quick backdrop is used to fill up the background of your level. It's quite easy to use. You right click, insert object, and choose quick backdrop. Originally it's just one color, which you can stretch out by selecting it and dragging, but it's a bit boring. If you go to where it says type, you can choose gradient, which is a bit more interesting, quite flashy looking. If you're doing a side view game, you might use this to make a sky backdrop, for example, that sort of thing. But the one I'm going to use for this game is a sand texture. To do this, go to type and choose motif. This makes it so that it's just a picture that's repeated over and over again, a bit like a texture in, say, Hammer. Click edit to edit it, and draw the picture that you want repeated. I'll just do this quickly. Lovely sand texture. Obviously, you'll spend more time on it than I will. Okay, and there you go, nice sand texture. And that's pretty much what a quick backdrop does. You can have multiple ones in the level, but I'm just going to leave it with one for now. A backdrop object is like an active object, but with just one frame of animation, and it can't move or anything like that. It's just simpler to use. So right click on the backdrop somewhere, insert object, and choose backdrop. This can be used to add more detail to the backdrop. Say you want some small rocks, you can draw some small rocks here. Obviously better looking than the ones I'm drawing right now. Add them around the place a bit. And that's about it for the backdrop object. If you want things to bounce off the backdrop object, you know, to stop bullets, to stop people walking through them, select the backdrop and go to the Runtime Options tab. Here you'll see Collisions, Obstacle Type, None. Click on None and choose Obstacle. But that isn't enough. As you can see here, they're still running through them. To stop this, go into the Event Editor, right click on New Condition. When the enemy, right click on the enemy, Collisions, Backdrop, make the enemy bounce. There we go. So with this you can make walls and cliffs and things that they can't run through. If you want bullets to be destroyed when they hit the backdrop, it's quite similar. Right click on New Condition, right click on the bullet, Collisions, Backdrop, go across to where the bullet is, right click, destroy. You won't be able to shoot through rocks now. If you don't want your person to be able to run through them, right click on New Condition, your person, Collisions, Backdrop, go across to your person, movement, stop. This option will only be available if your person can be controlled with the keys. If you haven't done the first tutorial that I've made on this program, you won't be able to do this stage. Same with the enemy. You have to have your person's movement set to one of these and not static. And that just about covers the entire tutorial. I hope this helps. The last collision we're going to do is between your person and the enemy. Now, later on I'll make it so that you lose health and everything, but for now we're just going to make it so that they bounce off you and you get stopped. To do this, go to the Event Editor, right click on New Condition, right click on either the enemy or you, it doesn't matter. Collisions, another object, choose the enemy, go across to your character. Now, you could destroy yourself at this point if you want, but I'm going to choose movement stop. And for the enemy, I'm going to choose movement bounce. Play the game. There. They now bounce off you. There you have it. The game is slightly more complex now. Obviously, it's still simple, but it's getting there.